Welcome back to Music for Your Bestie channel. This is Journey Choi and we are still talking all things social media. I know we've gone through social media management, social media marketing, social media creation, social media content, and today I'm going to talk about
the best kept secret of social media posting.
Have you heard of the word curation, content curation? What does that even mean? It says curation is the selection, organization, and presentation of online content, merchandise, information, etc., typically using professional or expert knowledge. The basic understanding of content curation. Let's talk about the three things that you will be learning today and taking away from my video. And one, that is how easy it is to curate relevant social media content. If you didn't know that, you will know it by the end of this video. Two, tips for scheduling and sharing your content across channels. Three, strategies on how to diversify your social media content mix. If these sound good to you, let's keep on watching and go on to the next. Oh, first up, let's talk about how to curate relevant social media content. When and why is it important to create relevant content? It's because they will help you demonstrate your industry expertise, expand your audience beyond your usual niche, which is why you're on the internet, not in your neighborhood. Three, more opportunities to contact followers. Four, provide a steady stream of engaging content. And it also adds 33% increase in click over on. I like to create my curated content for my strategy using this 80-20 rule. And 20% of your content should be about your brand. So people know, and especially if they're visiting you regularly or see your posts regularly, they'll see 20% of the time what your brand is all about. The other 80% should be devoted to timely, engaging, and very effective content strategy so it doesn't feel spammy. In order to do that, we're gonna teach you the tips for scheduling and sharing your curated social media content. First, I cannot stress this enough. You guys, plan ahead and consider the big picture. I'm actually recording this video a month ahead because that's been one of my goals from 2023 going for 2024. And this will help me stay organized by creating social media content calendar. I will never run out of ideas because I'm constantly brainstorming and writing down new content topics way ahead of time. And also allows me to be strategic. And in return, letting me create and schedule posts that will enhance the result of the marketing campaign that we all want for our social media. Another secret that I want to offer you is that you should totally go for a consistent cadence. I know other creators on socials talk about batching content and making a series, but that's like the same thing as what I'm saying. You can avoid spamming your audience while still being active enough to attract attention by creating a consistent posting schedule and just sticking to it. This will help you plan and schedule your post ahead and avoid any irregular posting pattern. I definitely needed that for 2023 and I think I have it now. You can also choose the best time to post because inside Social Bee, you can research your audience social media schedule and check out the analytics so you can find out the best time to post on each platform and customize your schedule for each social network this way. Then you can test, adjust, repeat as you go because we talked about it earlier in other videos as well. Assessing and looking through your analytics is something that you should be constantly doing. Are you guys ready to take some screenshots of this? Because this is gonna be important for you guys. Not all social media platforms work the same way because they each have their own unique algorithm. And these are some of the ideal posting frequencies and best posting times. I hope that's enough time. So let's get to the next slide. I want to recommend you follow the 411 rule, which means for every 6 posts you create on your social media channels, the 4 posts should be to entertain, to educate, while 1 post should be a soft shell and the other post should be a hard sell. So I know that's a lot of sell, sell, soft, hard, entertain. What am I saying? Okay, to be simple, to simplify things, 4 entertaining and educational posts. 1 soft sell that kind of lets them know what you do, and then 1 hard sell. This is a really good 411 rule that's gonna help you increase your followers' engagement and really to maximize your sales funnel and maximize your earning on social media. If you are not sure on how to monetize social media, then go and watch my video where I talk about 20 plus content ideas for each stage of funnel. And if you don't even know what funnel is, then that video is something that was literally made for you. Right, moving on. Use a social media scheduling tool like SocialBee. You don't have to use SocialBee. I've tried other management tools and they've not worked best for me and my model and my different accounts and brands I work with. And I ultimately made the switch back and forth, coming back to SocialBee. But feel free to try other things, because with these management tools, you can schedule bulk. You can have custom schedules, posting schedules. You can have evergreen posting patterns, as well as in-app content calendar and content expiration feature. So you can organize your posting content categories based on topics and schedule them to post alternatively throughout the week, and also create different content schedules for each social media and platform on the dashboard yourself. Evergreen posting patterns are really important because they get either requeued by individual posts or as an entire content category to maintain a consistent social media posting schedule with ease. And with in-app content calendar, you can view, adjust, and delete your scheduled content categories from your social media calendar super easily. And at least make sure you don't reshare the old content by expiring it at a certain time or a certain date or after a certain number of reposts. Make sure you don't reshare your old posts by expiring it at a certain date and time of your choosing. And the schedule setup on your dash looks like this. You can add posting time as many as you like. Under a category, this category is named promotional, and inside you can see all of the content stored. Now we're going to talk about how to diversify your social media content mix. What is a social media content mix? Let's talk about that. You can organize your posts in different content categories. You call them also pillars. I like to call them categories, because you can brainstorm content ideas that work well for your business to create content categories for each topic. Promotional, memes, quotes, industry tips, product tutorials if you already have it. Or three, you can schedule these categories alternatively throughout the week to diversify the content you post on social media. So for Monday, this example shows that you are sharing an IG feed pattern that's gonna look cohesive for your grid on the Instagram. And also we have a promotional content going out for Twitter, Instagram, another Twitter, and Facebook. While on other days, we have educational blog posts, promotional, and other things scheduled all throughout, making it a nice mix for your viewers. You can also experiment with multiple content platforms by alternating simple feed posts from like stories to carousels to reels, live, but just using all of the features, because that's how the algorithms will eat you up. You can also find ways to refresh your content. You can add emojis or make videos and other clips and recurate content. And obviously, we talked about this, you can reshare content from any other channel or creators by saving them and recreating. You can also follow the latest social media trends. That is by taking the time to learn about the latest trends that take place on the social media platforms you see, whether on TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, and start being an active participant by finding new relevant ideas, reaching and engaging with more people, and then going viral soon. Don't forget to create a holiday calendar for your content schedule as well, because this will find reasons to celebrate and keep your content really fun for all viewers. This will also help you make a list of national and international holidays that your audience celebrates, making it more inclusive for everyone. So make sure to use holidays as an opportunity to boost your sales by sharing discount codes or increase brand awareness by running some sort of giveaway contest. Last but not least, you can also share user-generated content as well. I know UGC is huge now. There's so many of creators. creators on online space creating these, and you can literally share content from your customers' perspective, gather testimonial reviews and product photos from other clients and previous customers as well, and also use your posts as a social proof to gain credibility. I hope the strategies that we went over today on how to diversify your social media content remix has been really helpful, and you have a better understanding on how easy it is to actually curate relevant social media content for your social media platform all over. And I hope that you will start using the tips, the scheduling tips and sharing tips to your advantage, and start sharing your content across all channels. We have a couple more episodes coming your way. No, we don't. We just have one more. That concludes 4 of the 5 All Things Social Media series that I am doing this month. Make sure to subscribe and like if you haven't already to continuously learning about all things related to music career. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned, and I'll see you soon. Music Career Bestie out.